guys have a good time on Cruise Through the Edge or what? For those of you that don't know me, I'm Eddie Trout, and it's been great to be in Prog World with you guys for the last 4 days. Thank you for having me. In my radio show live from here, we had so many great guests, discovered so many cool new bands, and it really was a blast. So we're reached the point now of our grand finale, and before I bring this guy out here, let me tell you a quick funny story. I'll never forget the first time we met. It was a number of years ago, maybe like 20 years ago. I get a call from a record company guy, and he says, we want to have somebody from Dream Theater on your radio show. And I said, okay, that's cool, who are you sending? Because I didn't really know much about the band at the time. And he said to me, well, we're going to send you the drummer. And I said, the drummer? What the hell talks to the drummer? You gotta send me like the main guy. I want to know the main guy. I said, no, you don't understand. He is the main guy. And I was like, all right, we'll send the guy up there and let me see what happens. And from that day, since that initial meeting, he is truly one of my best friends in the world. I love him to death. And I am so happy for him that he is embracing the music tonight that he was such an enormous part of making with Dream Theater for the first time since leaving the band. And I know he's worked real hard on putting this night together, and he's got a lot of surprises, so I'm gonna let him tell you about those surprises right now. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome and an early happy birthday to my dear friend, Mr. Mike Portnoy!
Quite a week since we celebrated the first part of my birthday, right? What a week. Everybody have fun? Well, here we are. This is the grand finale, huh? Well, we started my birthday bash with a few of my side projects, Flying Colors and Transatlantic. And the rest of tonight, we're going to be celebrating a lot more music. It was 20 years ago this year that I did my very first side project. And it was an all-instrumental band called the Liquid Tension Experiment. Yeah! And to me, one of the greatest things about it was working with the legendary Tony Levin. So please welcome to the stage, Mr. Tony Levin. Almost 10 years now since we've played together, so it's great to be reunited with this fine gentleman. Now this music is a serious tall order, so who the hell can play guitar and keyboards for this shit? Well, there's really only one guitar player I can think of that can nail John Petrucci's parts. Please welcome from the Neil Morse Band, Mr. Eric Gillette. Honestly, of all the guitar players I've played through in the years, this guy is Petrucci Jr., right? He is a guitar god! So who the hell is a keyboard shred master, huh?
Diego!
Who could it be?
Diego!
Please welcome from Hagen, Mr. Diego! Instrumental music, so I don't need this anymore. Who's taking this mic?
I heard it before.
right, kids, let's get this party started. What do you say? We'll be right back. It's all about the unveiling of the Chapman stick. Yeah. There it is! The most famous instrument in Prague. All right, we're gonna carry on with a song from the second LTE album. This is one called Acid Rain.
Thank you.
time for one more? I mean, it's waited 20 years. What's another 5 minutes, right?
Thank you.
crazy shit to cover. Thank you, Tony. Thank you so much, man. Should I stay back here? I'll stay back here. All right. Well, as you know, I have some unfinished business to attend to this evening. About 15 years ago, I put down the drink and picked up the pen and began writing a group of songs that would end up taking 8 years and five albums to complete the entire piece. And it's about a song about the 12 steps of recovery, which is something that was a huge part of my life for the past 15 years. And when I started writing about it, I knew I needed more than just one song to say everything that needed to be said. So I had this crazy idea of writing one song about steps 1, 2, and 3, and then the next album, a few years later, writing about steps 4 and 5, a few years later, writing about 6 and 7, and so on and so forth. And over the course of 8 years and five albums, I wrote about all 12 steps, and it was a huge thing for me to be able to write about this and integrate this into my life. It really changed my life, and it's a big reason of why I'm still here today with you. But the sad thing is, when I wrote the final chapter, I left Dream Theater and never had the chance to perform the entire piece in its entirety until this evening. So this is something that's been a long time coming, 15 years in the making, and something that I've been waiting for 15 years to do, and it's gonna be my birthday gift to myself that I'm also gonna share with you guys this evening. Now, once again, the big question, who the hell is gonna play this stuff? And obviously with Eric and Diego, we're well covered in the shred department. But I still needed a band to back me up and do this with me. And really, I could think of no better band that's more perfect, pretty much the tightest band out there, and the only band I could think of that could tackle this material and nail it. So please welcome Connor, Charlie, Richard, and Ross from Haken. Sound and we'll begin this mammoth opus.
Thank you. I'm sorry. Thank you. Thank you.
Michael Tejeida, Richard Henshaw, Charlie Griffiths, and Mr. Eric Gillette. So much, everybody. This was a dream come true for me, and the best thing I possibly could have asked for my 50th birthday. Thank you so much. You guys are the best fans in the world. Thank you so much. Be seeing you real soon. Take care. Good night.